Welcome to an example on how to solve a quadratic equation using the quadratic formula. The first thing we should recognize is that the given equation is in the correct form, or the form ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. So we'll start by identifying the values of a, b, and c. A is equal to positive 9, b is equal to positive 12, and c is equal to negative 1. So for the first step, we'll substitute these values into the quadratic formula. So we would have x equals negative b, that'd be negative 12, plus or minus the square root of the quantity b squared minus 4ac, that would be 12 squared minus 4, a is 9, and c is negative 1. All of this is divided by 2 times a, or in this case, 2 times 9. Notice for the first step, we didn't do any simplifying, we just performed the substitution. Now we'll begin to simplify. So we have negative 12 plus or minus the square root, 12 squared is 144. Then we have minus 4 times 9 times negative 1. That's minus negative 36, which is the same as plus 36. So it's important to take our time when simplifying underneath the square root. This value is called the discriminant. This is where many errors can be made. All of this is divided by 2 times a, or in this case, 18. So now we have x equals negative 12 plus or minus the square root of 144 plus 36 is equal to 180. Now we want to simplify the square root of 180. To do this, we're going to find the prime factorization of 180 so that we can find the perfect square factors of 180. So 180 is equal to 18 times 10. 18 is equal to 9 times 2, 2 is prime. 9 is equal to 3 times 3, these are both prime. And 10 is equal to 2 times 5, both prime. So the prime factorization of 180 has 2 factors of 2, 2 factors of 3, and a factor of 5. Every time we have 2 equal factors, we have a perfect square factor. So this will simplify, and so will this. So the square root of 2 times 2 is 2. The square root of 3 times 3 is 3. And we still have a 5 underneath the square root. So 180 simplifies to 6 square root 5. So now we have x equals negative 12 plus or minus 6 square root 5 divided by 18. But this does simplify. And there are two ways to show the simplification. The way I recommend is just to break this up into two fractions. Since we're dividing by a monomial, we can write this as x equals negative 12 over 18 plus or minus 6 square root 5 over 18. And now we can simplify each fraction separately. 12 and 18 share a common factor of 6. There are 3 sixes in 18 and 2 sixes in 12. And for the second fraction, there are 3 sixes in 18 and 1 six in 6. So this simplifies nicely to x equals, this would be negative 2/3 plus or minus, this would be square root 5 over 3. Remember, this represents two solutions. One solution is negative 2/3 plus square root 5 over 3. The other solution is negative 2/3 minus square root 5 over 3. The second way to simplify this would be to take this fraction here and factor the numerator. So let's go ahead and show that. Again, the other option is to write x equals, there's a common factor of 6 in the numerator, so if we factor out 6, that will leave us with negative 2 plus or minus square root 5 all over 18. We can write 18 as 6 times 3. In this form, we can see there's a common factor of 6 over 6. So the other way to express a solution as a single fraction would be x equals negative 2 plus or minus square root of 5 all over 3. So both solutions are correct, written in just a slightly different form. One thing we got to be careful about, though, is looking back at this in yellow, we cannot just simplify the 12 and the 18 because we cannot simplify across this addition and subtraction. So in order to simplify it, we either break it up into two fractions or first factor the numerator and then simplify with the denominator. I hope you found this helpful.